Hello students, welcome ulit sa YouTube channel natin. Again, Engineer Marvin here, and then today we'll try to continue yung discussion natin for roots of equation. Now, I already discussed two methods. You have the bisection and the regular falsi, or the false position method. So those methods are actually also known as bracketing methods. Basically, that was bracketing kasi meron tayong brackets or meron tayong lower boundary and upper boundary wherein our root lies somewhere in between. And then yun nga, we actually assume a new boundary sa bisection. The new boundary is yung sa middle, and then sa regular falsi naman, the new boundary is the parang linear, the intersection of the x-axis and the linear or the line connecting the f of x, yung bang sa boundaries natin. Okay? Now this time, meron tayong introduce na method which is an open method. Last time kasi parang closed or bracketing method kasi nga we have a boundary, lower boundary and upper boundary. This time, dito sa simple fixed point iteration, this is actually one of the open methods na i-discuss ko. So after nito, we'll try to discuss yung Newton-Raphson. So basically, dito sa simple fixed point iteration, same pa rin, we have a non-linear equation. However, yung assumption natin, since this is an open method, yung initial guess natin will actually be only one, unlike sa bracketing method na dalawa, di ba? Meron tayong XL and then meron tayong X sub U. Okay, now ngayon, isa na lang yung assumption natin. Okay? So anyway, let's try to look at the yan, example natin. So actually, napakadali. I like this method na madali lang yung simple fixed point iteration kasi two steps lang actually, and then this is actually very easy to write dito sa, madaling i-program lang ba? Unfortunately, we need to do some manual computations or manual parang algebra processes ba in converting our function into, di ba, yung original function natin is f of x, and then we want our function to be equal to 0 para makuha natin yung root. However, dito sa simple fixed point iteration, yung f of x natin, which is equal to 0, we need to convert that one such that yung x variable natin, we need to isolate one variable, which is one unknown. Okay? Ilagay natin sa left side, and then the right side of the equation contains also another unknown, which is actually the same lang, no? X lang. Anyway, I think mas madali, no? If I'll try to give an example. Okay? So basically, ang step one natin is to rearrange, di ba? Originally, this is our function, f of x is equal to 0, or kung ano man yung non-linear equation natin dyan. So we need to convert this one, yung function natin, into a function such that it will have this form, general form, x is equal to g of x. Basically, x is the variable, and then dito sa kabila is another function of x, okay? Na, ano din, bali isa lang yung ano natin, x lang dito, okay? So, step 2 naman is actually to set the initial guess for the first value of our iteration, yung unang value ng x natin. So basically, usually no, ang mga unang values dito is 0. But again, like I said sa mga previous videos ko, it is very important to properly select the initial value. Again, your initial value will actually will have the impact, no? Will have an impact on your computations, namely specifically the number of iterations. Mas malapit yung initial guess mo sa actual root. Okay, then mas maliit na lang yung iteration kasi mas madali kang aabot sa root. However, yun nga, if ever you have no idea of what is the possible root, it is always safe, no, to assume a zero value. Okay? So anyway, and then we need to solve after that. So once nakuha na natin, or once we already have a first assumption of x, we can now actually solve x I plus 1 or the second iteration. Okay? So I hope okay tayo dito, ha? So again natin, tingnan nyo dito. So bali yung x I plus 1 natin, okay, or yung second iteration natin, for example, this is x sub 2, yung second iteration natin, we can actually solve the second iteration by solving the yung g of x natin, tapos yung x natin dito is actually yung initial guess natin. Okay, again, medyo nakakalito pa din, but anyway, meron tayong example problem. So we'll be solving the same problems last time sa bisection and sa regular falsi, same pa din yung isosolve natin, and then we will try to compare kung mas counting na lang yung number of iterations. Now nakita natin last time na sa bisection it was actually a large number of iterations, di ba? Kasi nga medyo matagal mag-converge kasi depende kasi sa boundary natin. Pag malayo yung boundaries, then matagal. Pag malapit, then mas okay. Okay? Now, sa regular falsi, actually, mas lumit yung number of iterations natin. Now, let's try to solve daw dito sa simple fixed point if ever liliit pa ba compared to the regular file C. Okay? So anyway, let's try to open our Excel file muna. Ay, sorry. Ayun pala. Okay? So this is our Excel file last time sa regular file C. Tama. So sa regular file C, actually, hanggang 17 lang, no? 17th iteration tayo. Okay? Now, let's try to look at... Ay, sandali. Yan. Now, let's try to look at our number of iterations if we'll be using simple fixed point. Okay? Again, the first step, this is our function, di ba? This is a typical civil engineering function sa reinforced concrete wherein we are trying to solve for the concrete stress block A. Okay? Again, this is a nonlinear equation kasi nga we have a quadratic dito. Quadratic, di ba? So, again, this is our first equation. Yan. However, ang step one, sinabi doon na try to write the function as x. Okay? Try to write the function as x as another function of x. Or in this case, a as another function of a. A equals a function of a. So basically, let me try to draw this one. So we have our initial function dito, no? 200 times 10 to the 6 equals phi epsi prime I phi times 0.85 epsi prime ab. A times B, and then multiplied by D minus A over 2. So, ito yung function natin. Now, I want this one. I need to change this one. Kaso nga lang, ito lang yung medyo mahirap sa, well, not necessarily mahirap. This is basic algebra man lang, transposition and cross multiplication. So, we need to convert this one into a function such that this will become as A is equal to as a function of A. So basically, I just need to isolate one of the variable. Notice na dalawa yung A natin dyan. So I just need to isolate, di ba? Now, I think it's best no, to isolate this variable A compared sa variable A na nasa kabila. Kasi medyo mahirap tanggalin. Medyo mahirap i-extract yung A dito because of the bracket ba? Compared dito sa isa kasi nasa labas na. Okay, so yan na lang yung ilalabas ko, yung A na nandyan. So, to isolate this variable A, pwede kong ilagay dito, no? A is equal to, and then pwede kong ilagay, paano ba to? Di ba, pwede kong ilagay dito na 200 times 10 to the 6 over, divide the whole equation by 0.9, 0.85, epsi prime, and then 300 multiplied by 480 minus A over 2. Di ba? Now, I have A as a function of A. Di ba? Nag-gets niyo? Okay, so tapos na tayo sa step 1. Again ha, dito is, it's up to you no, on how you will actually create the function, no? X as a function of X. But it is always best to isolate the variable na nasa labas, okay, ng bracket. Kasi pag ito yung i-isolate mo, medyo matagal na. And then most of my students are actually asking, sir, paano namin yan gagawin? Actually, this is just a review from your algebra. Okay, ha? So, ang ginawa ko lang dito is actually cross-multiply lang. Okay, cross-multiply lang. Okay, so dito, notice na this is in the numerator ito. So, this will be, ilalagay ito dito sa denominator. Parang matitira is yung A na lang. Okay, so I hope okay tayo dyan. Sige. So, anyway, once nakuha na natin yan, ang next daw is actually to set a function or to set in an initial guess sa A. Ako, I want my initial guess to be, ano ba yung initial guess natin? Siguro, alam ko no, na ang A is actually a value from 0 to 480. So, siguro, ang initial guess ko na lang is 0 na lang siguro. Pwede kong initial guess ko is 0 para madali. So, if my initial guess is 0, therefore, A, pwede natin ilagay na AO or A1 na lang siguro. First iteration natin, okay, 0 yung value ng A. Okay? Now, ang second iteration natin, ang value ng A sub 2, diba? Ito yung, we need to use this equation. And then, if gagamitin natin yung equation na to, we need to set a value of A dito, diba? So, ang A natin dyan will be yung initial guess natin. Okay? Which is 0. So, let me try to copy this one sa calculator natin. Tingnan nyo, ito yung ilalagay ninyo sa calculator ninyo. Okay? So, again, please look at the calculator. Yan. 200 times 10 to the 6 divided by 0.9 times epsi prime times 20.7 times 300 times 480 minus A over 2. Okay, and then I will just actually, to solve for the function here, I will actually set A, I can press calculate, and then I will set A na ang initial guess ko 0. So, ilagay ko dito 0. Ano yung value ng A dyan? 87.7. So, meaning, ang second, ang value ng A2, or ang value ng A2 ko, or the value of A for the second iteration will be 87.707. Okay? And then after that, I will actually store this value dito. Pwede ko itong i-store sa letter A. And then dito, balik tayo dito sa itaas yan. Pag press ko na naman ng calculate, di ba? Same pa din yung equation natin. So, if I want to solve for the A sub 3 or the third iteration natin yan, A sub 3, to solve for the A sub 3, I will be using still, no? Yung equation, I will still use the equation. However, this time, I will set the value of A to be equal to our A sub 2. So, I'll press calculate and then I will set A to be 87.70729. Okay, so anyway, press equals ako. And then I have 96 for A sub 3. And then I will actually just repeat the process. Yan, and then 1. And then I will just actually repeat the process. So dito naman, A sub 4 ako. So to solve for A sub 4, I will still use the equation here. But this time, I will use, instead of 87, I will be using 96. So lalagay ko dito 96.5261. Okay, and then press equal. So, yan, 97. Diba? Ano yung sagot natin dito? I think 97 point something. So, diba, mas madali tayong mag-converge ito. Tingnan nyo. We are already almost in the answer, diba? On the root. Even though, apat pa lang yung iterations natin. And then, calculate na naman. So, 97.5119. Okay? So, yan. So, dito, sa A sub file, that's 97.6234. Okay? And so on, until we can actually arrive with our root. So, kailan natin malalaman na, uy, yan ang yung root natin. Obviously, if hindi na, nagbago, if nag-converge na ba. Okay? So, it's up to you to set the error. Okay? Kung gusto nyo na 0.01 or 0.001, walang problema. Okay? So, anyway, let's try to use now our Excel file and then let's try to check the actual number of iterations na gagamitin. So, I'll just actually write this one here. Kopyahin ito na lang to. Yan. And then ito, this will be my letter A. Yeah. So, ang A1 ko dito is actually 0, di ba? My first initial guess is actually 0. So, again, yung second value natin dito will be equal to ito. Yung equation natin, ha? So, I will just actually write the function dito sa Excel natin. Yan, yung 200 times 10 to the 6. Yan, kopyahin ko na lang. So, anyway, lalagay ko dito, 200 times 10 to the power of 6. And then, divide the whole equation by 0.9 times 0.85 times fc prime times 300 times 480 minus a over 2. Our a is actually itong nasa itas, a over 2. Okay, so I think okay na tayo dyan, di ba? So, ito yung first. Ito yung first natin, or second iteration natin. We have A to be 87. So, we'll just actually scroll this down. Yan. And then notice, we actually already converged dito pa lang sa 8, 9. Okay, sa 4 decimal places, no? Same na. 8 and 9. Unlike last time dito sa, you know, unlike last time dito na, actually, let's try to open na. Yan, diba? Oh, actually, dito pa lang, 11 and 12 para dahil dito. San ba tayo nag-converge? Aha, okay. Ah, okay. Actually, more or less, same lang sila, no? Tignan nyo, same lang sila sa Newton-Raphson at saka yung sa simple fixed point. Almost the same lang tayo ng kung saan nag-converge ba. But anyway, yun nga, mas madali yung simple fixed point in a sense na talaga. Kaunti lang yung processes na ginawa natin. We did not solve for FXL, FXU, FXR, di ba? We did not solve for this one and then yung medyo madali lang din yung XR natin. Okay? Unfortunately, yun nga, medyo kailangan natin ng parang analytical solution dito in converting our function such that A will be a function of A. Okay? So, again, ha, ito lang yung problema natin dito, which is to manipulate our equation. Yan, we need to manipulate our equation para A or X will be equal to a function of X. Okay, now let's try to solve daw yung second na function natin. Yan o. So, ito yung second function natin. Yan. Ay, sorry. Yan. So, sa second function natin, yan. Ay, sandali. Di ba? Ayan pala. So, ito yung second function natin. Anyway, let's try to convert this one or let's try to manipulate the equation para maging w as a function of w. So, I'll write the equation here. Ayan, 200 times 10 to the 6 is equal to phi epsi prime na 20.7 bd squared, that's 300 times 480 squared. And then index 1 minus 0.59 index. Okay? And then, let's try to solve that for the tension reinforcement index. So, w as a function of w. Parang ganun. Okay? So, what we will do is actually to choose either itong w, either this w or this w. So, which w should you isolate? Again, gana sabi ko, it's always best to isolate the w that is outside a bracket. Okay? Para diretso na. So, ito yung i-isolate ko. How do I isolate that one? Again, I will just actually cross-multiply the whole equation, di ba? Ito, ilipat ko na lang sa kabilang equation. Okay, but that will become a denominator. Again, na, this is from your basic algebra. Yan. So, this will become W is equal to, ano yan? 200 times 10 to the 6 over 0.9 epsi prime. 300, 480 squared times 1 minus 0.59 index. Okay? Now, let's try to use our, let's try to use our Excel na lang para madali. So, lipat tayo dito. So, copyahin ko to. Okay, and then, yan. So, this time, sabihin natin dito sa first, as first guess ko is 0 lang muna. So, yung second will be, again, I'll write the function. Ito, isulat ko dyan. So, that's 200 times 10 to the 6. So, 200 times 10 to the power of 6. And then, divide the whole equation by 0.9 times epsi prime. Times epsi prime bd squared. 300 times 480 bd squared. Times index, which is yung index natin, is actually... Yan, yung index natin will be yung nasa itaas times index. Ay, hindi pala, wala ng index. Times 1 minus 0.59 index naman pala. 0.59 times the index sa itaas. Okay, so yan. So, yung second natin will be 0.155. And then scroll down na natin. Di ba? Ang daling nag-converge, no? So, sa mga 7 iterations lang din. 7, 8, 9 iterations lang. Okay? Compared to our, you know, Newton, sa Newton wrap, I mean, sa simple fixed point, medyo matagal na converge, no? San tayo dito? Mga nandito pa. Sa 20, 22nd, 2021, yan. Nandiyan pa nag-converge. Dito sa, dito, san dito? Medyo malayo. Actually, let's check daw. Oh, actually, actually, ito na pala. Ito yung sa, ito pala yung bisection. So, sa bisection, medyo matagal, no? Nandito pa sa 20 plus. But dito sa fixed point iteration, nag-converge siya dito na sa 11. Diba? Somewhere dito sa 11 and 12. While dito sa simple fixed point, tingnan nyo, nag-converge siya dito pa lang sa 10, 10, 11. Anyway, yun nga, mas, although kahit same lang sila, no? Almost the same lang yung number of iterations, mas madali pa din yung simple fixed point in a sense na we do not need to solve the following values, yung FXL, XR, di ba? Medyo matagal, malaki, marami yung solution dito as compared to this simple fixed point. Okay? So, I hope okay tayo dito, ha? So, anyway, I think that's it, no? So, just remember, no, na if you're trying to solve, okay, pag nag-solve tayo for a non-linear equation and then we want to use simple fixed point, just change the function into x as a function of x. Okay? So, it is always best, no, na gamitin yung simple fixed point iteration if you can easily manipulate the equation, tanggalin yung isang variable. If mahirap, meaning we need to use another method. Okay? So, I think that's it. Maraming salamat sa panonood. And, again, if nakakatulong yung mga videos ko, do not, please do not forget to like and subscribe. It will actually help me a lot sa yun nga, sa YouTube channel ko to grow and yung tutorial business ko din. Okay, so, yun. Maraming salamat sa panonood and see you sa next video natin.